When are you visiting the Philippines?
Have you driven in the provinces?
So here we are, driving from Robinson Mall in Dumaguete and going to Honeycomb, which is on the waterfront, on the Boulevard. If you're leaving the front door, this is the front right exit from the parking lot. City Hardware coming up on the left. On the right here is the cockfighting ring. Very busy on the weekends. Robinson's Builders Hardware on the left. The main terminal for Ceres buses is coming up on the right. You can see the Ceres bus pulling out. You don't have to come to the terminal to catch a bus. You can stand on the side of the road anywhere along their route and flag them down. They'll stop for you as long as they have room available. Where the vehicles are going here on the right, that's the back entrance to the Robinson Mall. You can get to the parking lot from back there, turning at the McDonald's. In Dumaguete. This trike ahead of us here is the main form of public transportation. There's a few jeepneys that go out in the countryside. We can get to the Boulevard if we continued left there, but this is the back way of getting down to the Boulevard. It avoids the congestion if we continue straight there. You can see one of the white vans ahead of us here. Similar to the Ceres buses, they travel the up and down the island. There's another Ceres bus coming back to the terminal. The white vans are similar. You can just flag them down and along the route. And if they have room, they will stop for you. I prefer the Ceres bus. It's a bit cheaper, but for me, it's a bit safer. The vans tend to drive a bit wild for my liking. Ceres buses run up and down Negros, and they also, you can take it to go to Cebu. They'll run up and down Cebu Island as well. At Sibulan and San Jose, there's two short ferries that go over to Cebu Island. As you can see, I think that's the fourth bus we've seen in a few blocks. They're very frequent. So if we'd gone straight back there where I said we would avoid some congestion, this is where we would meet up with that traffic. So we avoided quite a bit of congestion and came on this back route. And this is just a few blocks from the start of the Boulevard. You can
see that license plate. It's not an official license plate. There's companies that make license plates because for some reason the government for years hasn't been able to produce license plates. So as long as you make a license plate in the design and the number of your vehicle, it's all good. I have an old car, so from 2011, so my license plate is an official license plate. There's an official license plate on the right, that red car. You can see the difference. Same with the motorbikes. Lindy's motorbike has a, it just went to a guy who makes it license plate because the government doesn't produce motorbike license plates. No idea what the backlog is in that department. Doesn't make sense in a modern society, but there you go. Someone can start a company making license plates for the government. So here we're coming up on the Boulevard. You've seen my other videos. This building on the left has been that way since I lived here in 2019. Not sure what's going on there. I know there's been some fighting about the reclamation project and a big development project that's held up around here. That might be part of it. So the reclaimed land is here on the right. It's a park. I'm sitting on reclaimed land. And here's the Honeycomb, great place for breakfast, lunch. They have live music at nighttime. Please subscribe if you haven't subscribed. We really appreciate your support. And if you have a chance, watch other long videos. They really help us get to our goal of being monetized. Thank you so much again. Humping. Take care. What's your advice for driving in the provinces?